petition dated 10th January 2014 arises out of an incident that occurred on 6 September 2013 involving the petitioner and the interested party, Honorable Rachel Shebesh. The incident led to the parties filing police reports. Those reports were then forwarded to the Director of Public Prosecutions, who made a decision to charge the petitioner with the offense of assault and Honorable Rachel Shebesh with the offense of causing breach of the peace. As the press in the petition show, the case is directed at impugning the decision of the Director of Public Prosecutions from his authority to commence criminal proceedings on the basis of the petitioner's fundamental rights and freedoms and the Constitution have been violated. The first applicant's application is that the county government has an interest in the matter and the events that led to the preferment of criminal charges occurred on its premises and while the petitioner governor was exercising lawful authority as a governor. The county contends that it has a legitimate interest in these proceedings as the alleged assault on the petitioner's head of county was an assault on the institution itself at the same time on its integrity and was done in the governor's office and in the course of execution of duties. Second application is brought by the political party and coalition sponsoring the governor. The grounds upon which it is brought is that the interested parties are aware that there has been an attempt to use all means to oust the ODM core leadership, which is in control of the Nairobi County, by removal of the petitioner through the instrumentality of the criminal process. They wish to demonstrate that the criminal law is being abused or used in ulterior purposes and motives, and they argue that political parties are entitled to join these proceedings as they are public entities recognized by the Constitution, Political Parties Act, and the Elections Act. The first respondent and interested party oppose the applications of grounds that the proposed parties do not have an identifiable legal interest given the nature of the subject matter, and that the issues raised therein are matters of evidence that can be brought in the proceedings on behalf of the respondent without the necessity of joining parties, and that it is contended that joining the applicants will obscure the real issues in controversy. As I stated earlier, the legal interest or identifiable stake must be in reference to the proceedings at hand. The central issue for determination in this matter is whether the petitioner's rights and fundamental freedoms have been violated by the exercise of the DPP's power to commence criminal proceedings against him. While this is an issue of general public interest, no doubt because of the position the petitioner holds, it is a personal matter as it involves his fundamental rights and freedoms and specific breaches of the Constitution in relation to him. The deposition of Lydia Ndegwa, the county secretary, sets out at paragraphs 4, 5, 6, and 7 the circumstances under which the alleged assault and breach of peace took place. These facts are the same facts recited by the petitioner supporting affidavit, hence there is no need to bring in further facts. As regards the issues of law and status of the governor, the petitioner himself is the governor and will be in a position to articulate them if indeed there are the grounds upon which the decision of the DPP is impugned. I therefore find and hold that the Nairobi City County has not established a basis to be joined